Hello, boy and girl. Welcome back to the adventures of Kirby Return to Dreamland. Last time, we killed a Sphere Doomer. And we actually see a lot of references from Kirby 64, like those spring things, but I think that they were in Kirby 3. So I'm not exactly sure. Dive Waldies. Fake Waldies. So a lot of these enemies just need one hit to kill them. So, yeah, like that basically, but you can combo on their corpse, on their already dead enough bodies to actually kill them. So yes, we got a power warp star. I just love this game. It's compared to Epic Yarn, this is the best Kirby game that's ever come to be since Epic Yarn. Now I know that's not very much, but it's better than Epic Yarn, obviously. We're going to be getting the cutter ability here. Now this can cut webs, ropes, anything that you can think, even the kitchen sink. But whenever you charge it completely with the one button, you can make it into the Super Boomerang. It's not as well as the Ultra Sword, but it's somewhat. It's not as strong as the sword. But yeah, you can actually redirect the yeah, like that. So yeah, the Super Suckage ability is actually very useful. Because it will allow you to get some stuff that you did not, like, abilities that you were unable to, that you lost. So yeah, that's a real good instance of the Super Suckage. And here I think that we're coming up to a mid, no, not yet. Okay, so here we have things that we can hold, which are like cannons, horns, or candles. Now, just beware that the cannon has a time limit on it. Just be aware of that. And once you throw it, it is still good. It doesn't keep shooting, thankfully. And yeah, whenever it starts going red, it's bad. But you can still use it, but not very useful, but it does give one free kill. And here we have the first instance of the spike ability. I don't think we've seen this ability ever since Kirby. I want to say Kirby 64? I'm not exactly sure, but I want to say so. But, yeah. Okay, awesome. I'm going to be grabbing the beam ability, one of the most recognized abilities in this entire series. So yeah, the spike ability, I'm guessing I didn't really get to show off that much, but I will be soon. So basically the spike ability, I want to say that that hasn't been in another game since Kirby, so-called 64. I just want to say, I'm not exactly sure, but I just want to say. So, I know a very cheap way to get past this boss, with this mid-boss. And it is doing the cheap move. And what you want to do with bosses is usually the indication that you want to destroy either corpse. So, yeah, the beam ability, if you have not played any other Kirby game, is the most recognized ability in all the Kirby games, just because it has a beam ability. And, yeah, the spike ability, has multiple different things. It kind of replaces the wheel ability, in this game a little bit, because it doesn't really go through, it always stops after one second, so, yeah, not really the best, but not really the worst. It's helpful in some ways. It makes you invincibility for, regular enemies, except Gordos. So yeah, let's grab this, and we have this spark ability. Not really my favorite, but not really my least. So, basically for some of the moves for this, you can shake the Wii Remote to charge up your power, or you can just press, hold down one, and it will just create an electrical field around you. And here, that is a arrow. And this is a lightning bolt type of thing. Well, lightning sphere, I should say. But whenever you do this, it creates some lightning, and whenever you do up one, it creates lightning, and whenever you do down one, you create lightning. So yeah, that's a little thing. A very easy way to get down here is just to do the easy way. Okay, so right here is a real cheap one. Cheaply placed energy sphere. Just because your first instinct is just to go through the door. So, yeah, that got me twice. Three times, actually. And so, yeah, by this point of the game, you might be just wondering, where's the bomb ability? Don't worry. Don't worry. That's what I said at the beginning of this game. Because usually the bomb ability is one of the first ones that you see in a level. So yes, here we get another fire ability, so I'm going to grab this, and yeah, oh no, I'm going to grab that, because it's more important here. Okay, so here is where this beam ability actually comes to play, because you can get some star pieces, or that's at least what I think that they're called. Okay, so getting rid of that Chuzu or whatever that thing is called is a good idea. We're going to be picking this key up. At this point of the game, you should really not be dying at all. At this point of the game, I only died. I died no times. Like, this game so far is real easy. Unless you fall in the pit, then it will get real hard. Cause pits are not fun. Just ask, Kid Icarus. He's not fun. He's just cheap. Kid Icarus is cheap. And I dare not to call him by what people call him. Because I really do not like him. Okay, so here we have an instance of a race. Here. That little thing at the bottom of the screen is a weird thing that I have no idea what name it is, and I'm not going to ask what its name is. So basically, what you have to do is beat it and destroy it. Free kill. Die. So yes. Usually those fights, well, those races, usually lead you to a star, no, energy sphere, whatever. And it will occasionally always lead you to one, or somewhere near the right path to going to one. And, yeah. So yeah, I think for in this first world, I'm just going to be putting two stages per episode. If I miss one, I know where it is because I literally gone through this entire game. It's kind of not that hard, but it's... Okay, so next time we're going to be going to stage 4. Then we're going to be going over to this sapling to work our magic. And goodbye, my friends and loyal subscribers.